So if you're a fan of Casey Neistat, you've probably seen in his recent videos, he started to use kind of a glitch transition. I've gotten a lot of questions on my other After Effects tutorials on how to do like this Casey glitch effect. And before this tutorial starts, I just want to say, I understand that a lot of you guys out there are huge fans of Casey, and I'm huge fans of Casey as well. But if you just completely copy his style, you're never gonna create your own. It's definitely a good place to start, but you don't just wanna sit there and create content that is exactly like Casey's, because if you never try new things and you're always trying to emulate someone else, you'll never create your own style or create your own way of doing things. And that's what filmmaking is all about. It's all about experimenting and figuring out what works best for you and developing your own style. I just wanted to get that out there before the tutorial, but let's hop into After Effects.
Alrighty, let's jump right into this. For the few of you that don't know who Casey Neistat is or haven't seen some of his recent vlogs, this is the effect I'm referring to. See this right here, Casey and his friends, this is like the David Dobrik vlog. And then right here, it just starts to have this little glitchy effect. And then there's another one right there. So this is the effect I'm gonna be showing you how to accomplish today with Premiere and After Effects. So go ahead and drag the footage that I provided into a new sequence down here on this icon. Like always, the link to all these project files are in the description, so check that out and download it if you want to play along. So this is the shot we're going to be working with today. Basically all it is me going up, opening my door, and getting an Amazon package off my porch. But we're going to be doing a cool transition right here. So I'm going to do it basically right as I unlock the front door. I'm going to cut in Adobe Premiere. So obviously this tutorial is starting in Premiere, and I'm gonna explain that in a little bit. So figure out the position in your footage where you wanna cut, and then obviously where you wanna cut to. So I'm gonna cut there to right there. So now obviously as you play it, it just cuts. But how are we gonna spice that up? Basically, go to the split in your footage, hold down shift, and click the right arrow key twice, and that'll fast forward 10 frames in your sequence. And then go back to the original cut, hit shift again, and click left on your keyboard twice, and then hit C for the cutting tool and click again. And basically what you're doing is you're gonna nest this. And nesting essentially is gonna put this in its own sequence. So you click it, and then this is in this sequence, and then it's one entity over in this other sequence. And then you're gonna right click and click replace with After Effects composition. And this is gonna open up After Effects with that nested sequence, and it's gonna be one clip on your timeline. And then if you do wanna make changes, you can go back in to the original footage as well, because it makes it a composition in After Effects. And this is why I love After Effects and Premiere so much, is because they're so well integrated. So open up your linked composition here with one track, and then I'm gonna drag this glitch effect into its own composition down here just to show you what we're working with. This is an element that I have provided. All it is a pre-keyed glitch distortion, so I've already gone through the trouble of making this and including it in the project file. So I'm just gonna exit out of that real quick. So I'm basically just gonna drop this on top of the sequence, and then right there you can see it's a pretty cool little digital distortion. And we're gonna go to where the cut is on our footage. So the cut is right there, and we're gonna start at 2 frames before. So if you hit T on your keyboard and keyframe the opacity, turn it down to 35 on the start frame, and then right over the cut, change it up to 100, and then in the next 2 frames, just fade it out. So this is gonna be the start of our effect. I went ahead and extended to the first frame. So that's gonna be the start of the effect, but how are we gonna make this more interesting? And the answer to that is you wanna duplicate your glitch effect footage by hitting Control D on your keyboard, Command D on a Mac, and then turn off the top layer, click on your nested sequence down here, and then in your effects and presets tab, go over here and type in displacement map. And you wanna drag that onto the nested sequence 3. If you click on this displacement map effect and you click right here, you can click the source of where your distortion is gonna occur. So I'm gonna click the second layer, the one that is on right now, not the top one, but the duplicated one on the bottom. So I'm gonna click that, and what that's essentially gonna do is if you turn it off, so if I make this more intense right here, so basically what this is gonna do is distort your footage based on the color profiles of your other layer. We obviously don't want this occurring for the full length of the clip. So what we're gonna do is keyframe the horizontal and vertical displacement. So go to the beginning frame on your glitch effect and drop down the nested sequence. And then what you wanna do is go over here to the displacement map and click a keyframe for the max and vertical displacement. On that first frame, set it to 0 for both of them, because obviously you don't want it to start displacing. And then hit U on your keyboard, and that's gonna bring up all the keyframes for that layer. And then go forward to where the cut occurs right there. Just go ahead and drag it up to where you see fit. This is, again, like I always say in my tutorials, where you need to kind of experiment. So for me, I'm gonna start the keyframe at 0 and then go forward to the frame where it cuts. And I'm gonna drag it up to 50 because I think 50 looks good. And then I'm gonna fade it out over over the next like three frames and then set it back to zero. So now if we preview our clip, we're getting a nice little actual distortion here on top of our footage. So then go ahead and turn back on the top glitch effect, and then you don't want it to be the same alpha obviously as the other one, so I'm just gonna scale it up, holding shift on my keyboard to maintain the same aspect ratio, and then just move it around a little bit, just so it's not in the same exact place as the other distortion. So that already is looking pretty awesome, but there's a couple more things we can do to really polish off this effect. So what I'm gonna do is select the glitch effect and the nested sequence and right click it and click pre-compose, and then move all attributes into the new composition. And this is gonna create all that into one layer. And then if you wanna edit that, you can double click and go into the other pre-comp and make changes there. But the reason I'm doing this is because I'm gonna duplicate this three times and then turn off the audio, because obviously that'd be very loud. And then go over to your effects and presets tab and type in levels. And then we're gonna drag levels on to each one of these layers. So for the top layer, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here in the effect controls and click levels and hit red. And then I'm going to drag this all the way to the right. And that's going to make your frame all red, and you're probably like, what the heck, this looks dumb. But just bear with me for a second. And then turn that layer off, go to the next layer down and type in green, and then drag that all the way to the left as well. You're going to have a green footage. Again, bear with me. And then one more time for that bottom one, hit blue, drag it all the way to the left. And then you can turn them all back on. Now highlight all the layers, click one, hold shift, and then click the top one. Hit T on your keyboard, that's gonna bring up the opacity keyframes. Drag it down to zero, hit the stopwatch so it records all your keyframes. Click there. I'm actually gonna go to one after the beginning of the glitch effect. And then I'm gonna go to the frame where it cuts. So I'm gonna drag it up right to 50%, and then two frames in the future, just drop it back down to zero. So this is just gonna keyframe in that color change, but it doesn't look super cool yet. So what we're gonna do is select all your layers again, hit P on your keyboard, and then hit the stopwatch for the position keyframe, drag forward the two frames, and then basically what you're gonna do is offset these frames just ever so slightly. Obviously if you do too much, it's gonna create a little weird border effect, but, and then I'm gonna copy and paste this position keyframe back to the other one so it returns to its original position. So this just creates a cool little distortion effect, and then obviously you can also hit T on your keyboard again and drag up the opacity if you want it to be more intense or less intense. So this just creates a little stretch effect and a cool little discoloration thing that Casey also did. So if we preview that, that's looking pretty cool. That's very kind of disturbing to watch over and over. But I'm gonna add one more thing to polish this off, and what I'm gonna do is right click and click new adjustment layer. And then I'm gonna go over into the effects and presets tab and type in TV. And then you're gonna bring a bad TV 3 weak over onto that. And this is gonna look crazy, but fear not. Basically, if you don't understand adjustment layers, this adjustment layer is gonna affect everything underneath it. So obviously we don't wanna affect the actual glitch effect, so if we drag it below the glitch effect, it's not gonna affect that. So that's the best way to understand adjustment layers. So I'm gonna turn this off real quick and hit T on your keyboard for opacity, and then go forward to the frame where it cuts, hit opacity, and maybe set it to like 75, because it's a pretty intense effect and you probably don't want everything. Go back two frames, turn it back on, and then set it to zero, and then forward two more frames from the cut, hit zero again. So this basically is just turning on an old, I'm gonna preview this so you can actually see what the hell is going on. This is just gonna create like a little warpy TV-ish effect. This doesn't look exactly like how Casey did it, but you can set it to be less opacity, you can set it to be 100%, depending on the effect you're going for. You know, it really depends what you're going for. I'm gonna set it more to like, probably like 35, so it's not super intense, but you still get that, you know, kind of scan line effect. So if you preview this one more time, that is the glitch effect. And I think that looks pretty sweet. So if you go back into Premiere, sometimes it takes a little time to update, but mine is already updated. So if you drag right here, it's obviously gonna be red. So what you wanna do is when it updates, just hit enter on your keyboard, and that's gonna preview that footage so that it's rendered out. For the very, very final touch, go into Premiere and then click effect and controls, and then scale to like 104. And then obviously you want to scale your other footage to like 104. That scale change is just going to get rid of the border here on the effect when the distortion occurs. So there's a final effect, but there's one final thing we're going to do. I included in the project files a couple sound effects, and I'm just going to drag one on. And this is what Casey really used to sell the effect well, is you want to drag to where the frame is, and then obviously you know how sound effects works. that's just gonna create a sound effect where that transition occurs. And that was loud as loudness. You know, just adjust how you see fit, especially if you're talking, not talking. And that wraps up for this tutorial. If you want to, you can go ahead and check out some of my other tutorials. I'm gonna leave a link right now. If you wanna be sure to never miss another tutorial or video from me again, just go ahead and click notifications on for my channel. YouTube's not great at sending out new videos to your subscribers all the time, but if you hit that bell, you'll be sure to never miss an upload from me again. All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Peace.